Hi guys, James here. I hope you're all doing super well. I know it has been a hot minute since I uploaded on YouTube. My computer was out of storage, my ring light broke, my camera broke. A lot has gone on, but I'm here, that's all that matters, and I'm filming for you guys, which I am so excited to get back into the YouTube game. I just had my last final a few days ago, so thank God it is finally summer, and I wanted to teach you guys today how to do my go-to summer freckle look. I did a super soft base with no eyeshadow, winged liner, and freckles, and of course this purple lip, but I do provide you with other lip options just in case you don't want to go crazy, so make sure you keep on watching if you want to learn how to do this makeup look. I'm going to start off by priming my face today using my Benefit Professional Primer. I just finished finals at school, so my skin has been absolutely horrible from all the stress acne I've been getting. No offense, but I didn't even do that well in all my finals, so it wasn't even worth it. For foundation today, I'm going to be using my Makeup Forever Ultra HD stick in the shade Y315. This is literally gone, so I'm going to be using a Morphe E57 brush to scrape this out of the tube to apply it to my face. Normally I would just draw it on, but when you use this as much as I have, you can't really do that anymore. I love this foundation for the summertime because it is oil-based, but it's super dewy and it sets on the skin really nicely. It looks like natural skin as opposed to like a layer of cake over your face, so I really, really love this foundation and would definitely recommend it to all of you guys out there. I'm now gonna take my damp beauty blender and just blend this into the skin super seamlessly. I'm now gonna go ahead and highlight and conceal my face using the Too Faced Born This Way concealer in the shade Light. These concealers are brand new, I've never used them before, but everyone's been saying amazing things about them, so I'm very excited to try them out. This is my first time ever using it on my face, so honest review time, here we go. I'm also going to take this and I'm going to do one really thin line down the tip of my nose. I've been practicing my nose contour lately, still not a pro at it, my nose is humongous, so I'm doing my best to try to make it work. If you have any tips, please let me know, but as soon as I perfect this, I'll make a tutorial for you guys, I promise, so you can have a snatched nose like me in the future, because right now, let's be real, it's not too snatched. I've done it once, and you saw it on my Instagram. Will it ever look that good again? Probably not. We'll have to find out. Once again, just taking my damp beauty blender, I'm gonna blend this into the skin. I really like how this is blending out. This is really nice. To set my face today, I'm gonna be using Coty Airspun Powder and my Morphe E41 brush. I'm just getting a little bit on the brush, so I'm gonna tap it off because I wanna set my face with powder, but I don't wanna cake it on like usual because we still want a little bit of that dewy coming through. And obviously we're gonna be using some highlighting powders later, but this will just help it to be matte, but not flat. Love a good rhyme. If you want, you can use my coupon code James for 10% off all Morphe products. I love their brushes and you really should too if you haven't tried them. To bronze my face today, I'm going to be using my Benefit Hoola Bronzer and my Morphe M435 brush. This brush is my holy frickin' grail. I'm going to attempt to contour my nose. Please wish me luck. This shit is so hard. I'm using my Hoola Bronzer. Oh, that's a problem. I'm not going to panic. We can fix this. Someone really needs to explain to me how to actually do this because this never works. My nose always still looks so bad. I don't understand. Well, this is something to say the least. I am going to let this sit for a few minutes and pray and maybe sacrifice something to the gods and hope that this comes out okay. Update, still looks bad, still looks big, still looks crusty, so I'm gonna move on because clearly I don't know how to do this very well and I don't want to waste any more of your time. We're all set with the face for now, so I'm gonna zoom you guys in so we can do the eyebrows. I'm gonna be using my Anastasia Dip Brow in the shade Dark Brown as usual and my Anastasia number 12 brush. This eyebrow, she's the real deal. She goes to church every Sunday, she gets straight A's, she doesn't do anything wrong, no drugs, no sex before marriage, like, this is the good brow. This one, on the other hand, she is the ugly one. She's the ugly stepsister, she gets no men, she got kicked out of the house for doing too much weed. Doing too much weed. This joke is suddenly over. I'm gonna start off this brow by drawing the outline on the bottom, so I never start right in the front, I always start a little bit outwards just so we can get that nice ombre insta-brow fade. Grabbing a little bit more of my brush, I'm going to define the tail of the brow. This should be where your brow is darkest, so you're going to want the most product in this region. being your brows on camera is really something that is so challenging. You should never aspire to do. It is not fun. 0 out of 10. Would not recommend. It's very hard. The angle never looks good. Half the time your brow comes out shitty anyway. Now I'm just taking the excess product that's left on the brush and I'm making little flickety doodahs in the front of the brow to define it, but not to make it like really, really dark, because we want, like I said, the nice fade, the ombre brow. This did not come out as bad as I was expecting. So yes, follow that if you're gonna do your brows. Now I'm gonna go in and clean up the bottom of the brow. I'm gonna use the same concealer as before, the Born This Way one and the Morphe E43 brush to make sure it's super defined. Similar to what I said before, you really want to start in the middle of the brow and blend outwards as opposed to just starting from one end and going right to the other. It will help you blend nicer and make it look really, really natural and just defined as opposed to a white line underneath your brow, which never, ever, ever is cute. To finish off this brow, I'm just going to go to my tinted brow gel from Anastasia in the shade Espresso to set all the hairs in place so they don't move throughout the day. And this is a finished James Charles brow. I'm gonna go ahead and do the other one off camera and then we can get started with the eyes. For this look today, I'm actually gonna do no eyeshadow, but I am gonna teach you guys how to do a bomb ass wing. For this, I'm gonna be using my Kat Von D Tattoo Locket Liner in Trooper. I like to make my wings more straight out as opposed to straight up because my eyes are very hooded and my eyebrows obviously have zero arch to them. So this really flatters my face shape and helps to widen everything out. Now that we have one wing done, once again, we pray to the Lord, make us a few sacrifices because now we have to do the other one, and hope to God that it's even. If your liner isn't even, it's okay. Trust me, most people's probably aren't. It's the thought that counts. For mascara today, I'm going to be using my Benefit Roller Lash. This stuff is my holy grail. I absolutely love it. I've raved about it since the beginning, and it's my ride or die. I'm just applying a really light coat because I am going to be wearing falsies with this look, so I don't want a lot of mascara. For lashes today, I'm going to be applying Eskido Lash Mapolitan Lashes. They are so cute and they start off really, really tiny and get huge as they go out. So I absolutely love this shape of lash and it flatters my face super nicely and it will probably flatter yours too. There we go, that's the eyes completed. I'm gonna go ahead and zoom out now so we can finish the rest of the face. To highlight my face today, I'm gonna be using a mix of two Anastasia shades from their glow kits. I'm gonna be using Sunburst and Summer. I'm applying these with a damp Morphe M501 brush. I absolutely love this brush for highlighting. It's so nice and so precise. It's obviously extremely worn out because I use it and rub it all over my face all the time, but it still does its job.
This is what you came for. Lightning strikes every time.
I just went ahead and added some fake freckles quickly. If you don't know how to make fake freckles and you would like to, you can feel free to check out this video, which I already uploaded on my channel on how to make fake freckles. So go ahead and watch it. They're super trendy this summer. For my lips today, I'm going to be going with Ofra Liquid Lipstick in the shade Purple Rain. This liquid lipstick is one of my favorite shades from Ofra. It's so cute and I feel like it's perfect for summertime since people are finally willing to wear bright colors, thank God. But if you don't want to wear a purple lip, I get you, girl. I feel it on a spiritual level. Not every day is a purple lip kind of day. So I went ahead and I give you guys two other lip options. This is Ofra's Laguna Beach. It's a nude pink color and it's one of my absolute faves. This last lip option is Ofra Liquid Lipstick in the shade Venice. It's another one of my absolute faves. It's so cute, and if you want to keep it really bright for summer, but you don't want to do a bright-ass purple, this is the perfect shade for you. Basically, the point of this is that this look is really cute, and you can choose whatever lip color you want, and you'll still look good, so you get the best of all the worlds. All the liquid lipsticks I mentioned in this video tonight are from Ofra Cosmetics. As you guys know, they're one of my absolute favorite brands, and I talk about them literally all the time. In my opinion, their liquid lipstick formula is the best on the market, so if you decide to purchase from them, please tell them I said hi, and you can use code JCHARLES for 30% off your order. You're welcome. I really, really hope you guys enjoyed this video. I had so much fun getting back into the swing of things and filming for you guys now that I have my equipment and this beautiful new setup. I'm gonna try so hard to get out as many videos as I possibly can for you guys this summer. I really wanna grow my YouTube and grow this community with you guys and be one big happy family. As much as I do love Instagram, it's so much easier on YouTube to actually let your personality shine through and really become a real person instead of just an artist with a nice backdrop and nice looking makeup. If you like this video, please make sure to give it a big thumbs up down below and subscribe if you haven't already. Share it with your friends, tell everybody that J. Charles Beauty is making his YouTube comeback. I'm really excited for this, and I hope you guys are too. That's all. I love you guys so much, and I will see you in the next video. Bye!